on the Medical Watch tonight, using brain power to hand patients greater independence.
Medical reporter Dina Baer shows us how.
We use our hands every day, but rarely appreciate the incredible tools. One man who grasped that value long ago has made it his life's mission to give amputees a hand.
Artificial limbs are constantly evolving.
So this is actually lighter than an average human hand.
Armed with human-like movement.
Oh!
And quick reflexes.
It's the fastest bionic hand in the world.
The latest model is quite durable.
Yeah!
The whole idea for building bionic limbs started when I was actually 7 years old.
On a family trip to Pakistan, Aldil Akhtar met an amputee.
And that's the first time I met someone with a limb difference. She was my age, missing her right leg and using a tree branch as a crutch.
The experience ultimately inspired the neuroscientist to invent the ability hand. He started building prototypes 7 years ago at the University of Illinois.
There are six motors inside the hand. Each one controls flexion and extension in each of the fingers, and then one for thumb rotation as well.
Made from carbon fiber, rubber, and silicone, there's science behind its strength.
It's also the first hand on the market to give users touch feedback.
Touch triggers a vibration.
So they have pressure sensors that are built in here, and there's a vibration motor that's in here. So whenever I touch this, you can actually feel a vibration.
Dan St. Pierre lost his hand in a work accident in 2009.
I was a commercial diver. I was doing some work underwater, and my hand got trapped into a machine.
The father of two young children tried out a few other devices before connecting with Adil.
His control is really good on this thing. Yeah.
The ability hand is a type of myoelectronic prosthesis. Microcompressors, motors, and internal wiring work in concert to help the amputee execute movements. At his workshop in Joliet, Illinois, David Rotter builds prosthetics of all shapes and sizes. A skilled craftsman, he also helps keep high-tech options grounded in practicality.
If it works correctly, it doesn't seem complex for the user. In the past probably 15, 20 years, there's been an explosion of technology.
Sensors have changed the way prosthetics operate. They capture energy generated by existing muscles and send it to the artificial limb as a command.
And the way this hand is controlled is through muscle sensors that we place on your residual limb. And then by flexing those different muscles that are still present, you can actually use that to control the hand to do different movements.
Once you start doing it, it becomes second nature.
Different motions are programmed through an app.
Okay, and now you should be able to rock on.
Yeah.
Then stored on the prosthesis via Bluetooth.
He's able to do different grips with it. So here's like a tripod grip that you can use for grasping objects in daily living.
From everyday tasks to workouts.
It has given me the ability to get back to working out with two hands as opposed to one. It definitely helps doing push-ups now.
The purpose is to empower amputees.
Sorry. You just have to find what really works for you and just really work that tool.
Yeah, nice.
The ability hand ranges in cost from $10,000 to $20,000, but it is covered by many insurance plans and Medicare. Adil is hoping to start a nonprofit to help all those who need access to advanced bionic limbs.